Police gave us an alarming snapshot today into just how arrogant and dangerous scores of Sydney drivers are. New stats from the past 6 months show that thousands are still speeding, driving drunk or without a seatbelt. Erin Bell joins us now. Erin, worst of all perhaps, they're putting their kids and others in serious danger.
That's right, Sandra. Police revealed today that while the number of fatalities is slightly lower compared with this time last year, they're still shocked by just how careless drivers are, not only with their own lives, but with their passengers.
A police car travelling along a country road, then this, as a driver narrowly escapes a deadly front-on collision.
I need to know what happened there, basically, because I just saw my life flash before my eyes.
And here, police cameras capture a swerving truck moving back into its lane just in time. These are the moments emergency services are desperately trying to prevent, but they feel like a broken record.
The fact that you can get to somewhere a minute quicker, it just doesn't make it sense when potentially you could be injured.
Speeding still tops the list for penalties, with more than 100,000 fines issued so far this year. 10,000 were charged with drink driving, 15,000 busted using their mobile phones, while 10,000 were caught without a seatbelt. Alarmingly, 2,000 of those were children, not strapped in by their parents.
It's amazing in this time that people don't put a seatbelt on a young child.
Today marks the beginning of a high priority time for police patrolling our roads, and that's because historically, the last few days of school holidays are the deadliest.
It's where people take the most risk. We're urging motorists, you know, if you're fatigued, don't drive. If you've been drinking, don't drive. Don't use your mobile phone, and for God's sake, don't speed.
Especially as the chances of getting caught just got higher, with two private companies today awarded a $33 million contract to roll out even more mobile speed cameras. Of course, catching dangerous drivers is not the problem. It's getting them to slow down.
And Sandra, New South Wales motorists can expect to see at least 39 of those new speeding units on our roads as early as January.
Erin Bell reporting there. Thank you.